Israel has rejected a US call for it to retreat behind pre-1967 war borders and withdraw from the occupied Palestinian territories. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who's in Washington for talks, says it's a concession he will not make. Well, RT's Kristine Frazao explains why America's efforts have for decades failed to bring peace to the Middle East.
It is a scene all too familiar in this region, a protest on Israel's border that leads to violence. Here, it was the May 15th protest marking what Palestinians called Nakba, or catastrophe, the creation of the State of Israel on this date in 1948. For Israel, it was a matter of security, according to Dan Pollack, co-director of the Zionist Organization of America.
I don't know what any country would do when people gather on your border and come across it in violation of the law.
But for Palestinians, it is the continuation of a seemingly endless fight for an independent Palestinian state. A fight in which U.S. leaders try time and time again to play chief negotiator, from President Carter to Reagan to George H.W. Bush to President Clinton, George W. Bush, and now the Obama administration.
Please have a seat. We believe the borders of Israel and Palestine should be based on the 1967 lines with mutually agreed swaps, so that secure and recognized borders are established for both states.
An unusually blunt endorsement of an end to Israeli occupation of Arab land by a U.S. president. The idea was immediately rejected by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Israel argues peace cannot come at the cost of its security, with continued Palestinian rocket attacks.
But there is one thing both sides actually agree on. When it comes to the U.S. role as mediator, its approach, they say, is all wrong.
American policy is built on misconceptions, a wrong view of the causes of the conflict, and a prescription that doesn't stand up to even the most casual scrutiny.
The question is not why don't we have a solution at this point, but why on earth should we expect to have a solution with the system as it is today?
Yusuf Munayor with the Jerusalem Project says talk is cheap when the U.S. says it's engaged in the process of a two-state solution, but is funding and supporting behavior by Israel that's simultaneously working against it.
Paying somebody, bribing somebody to change their behavior doesn't work when you've spoiled them rotten.
A recent example, in November, the U.S. offered several billion dollars in military assistance to Israel if it put off the construction of Jewish settlements for 3 months.
So regardless of what Obama says or how he says it, and he says it better than Bush, but what he does is the same.
The costs of peace are high.
High costs abroad and at home. Pro-Israel money accounting for between one quarter and one third of all donations to the major political parties. A concern for many, including former U.S. Congresswoman Cynthia McKinney.
They bought the executive branch. They bought the legislative branch.
Pro-Israel campaign contributors totaled nearly $12 million in 2010, far higher than other major donors, making increasing the pressure on Israel a politically daunting prospect, especially with elections 18 months away.
We are Palestinian. This is our land.
But with the need to show support for the Arab Spring and a reconciliation between the two Palestinian factions, U.S. leaders may be feeling the pressure to make a push. Yet again, Kristine Frazao, RT.